Good morning, my friends. Welcome to Dave's Skillet. Sorry I've been away so long, but I moved from my past location to a new location, still in Chicago. But today, we're going to have a beef roast. I got a chuck roast here. It's 2.23 pounds. I've gone ahead and removed some of the fat because I didn't want it. Just a little chunk right there. I took that out. Otherwise, we would have a lot of grease in the pot. I'm gonna put two chicken cubes in the crock pot because we're gonna do a crock pot today. And we're gonna be using my favorite, I'm sure yours. Yep, use your favorite beer, whatever you got, that's fine. That's completely up to you. We're gonna season this meat now. Some pepper on it. And some salt. Using kosher coarse. Both sides. Pat that into it real good. Flip it over. This has been sitting on the countertop while I did my prep work for the mirepoix, which is going to be celery, carrots, and onions, and garlic. Yeah, get that all worked into it, just like that. Right, now, need about, probably about 2 tablespoons of flour. We're gonna work that into it as well. Gonna braise the meat, brown it rather, and then that'll be about 3 minutes on each side. Put that into it real good. I've also got some mushrooms I'll be adding to it. There we go. It's looking good now. I use the skillet because I don't want to dirty another pan to do this. I'm also going to be adding some corn on the cob. The recipe that'll go in later on, so don't want to overcook stuff. And that's our mirepoix. It's just a rough cut, really. You've noticed I've added the flowers of the celery. That's just added flavor, really. So I'm gonna put about half of this in cooker. I'll do that now. And then the other half will go on top. There, that's good. Now, put that in the sink for right now. Need some beer. No, I won't be drinking. Doctor says my drinking days are done, so I can still cook with it. Okay, now, we're going to have this on high. There we go. Slide that over. I got to park this for a second. I went ahead and dried the meat earlier because it was a bit wet. And I didn't want it wet, so. Gotta get the excess flour out of the pan here. A bit much in there. This is real easy to do, this crock pot thing. If you're going to chew a roast, I highly recommend it. It's a no-brainer. I mean, it's going to come out really good. I'm not really trying to go for the roast thing, but what I want is some pulled pork-style beef for another recipe. And This is the best way to get around doing that. It will be pork tender when I'm done, which is exactly what I need to do. I wish it would cook quicker, but it won't. Woo. Now I need some butter. Turn the stove on about a number 5 electric. Going to be the only real spice I use. I won't be adding anything else to it. No thyme or any other recipe or spice. And we will be back as soon as that's ready. So we're going to go ahead, throw this in. You want the skillet hot, which it is. And that's going to be about 3 minutes on each side. I got 41 on the stove now, 441. Yeah, it's early in the morning for Dave. That's okay. Because this is going to be the crock pot. That's going to take about 4 hours. So, yeah. I want it for lunch. It's got to be good for lunch. So when this is 444, I get to flip it over. Meanwhile, I'm going to take one of these corn on the cobbies, cut it in half. I've got to chuck the thing off. Yeah, that's easy to do. I want to leave all that on, especially all that fiber. You didn't see it, but the best way to get all that fiber off is just do the old Indian burn. Remember that? Ah, remember that, Judy? God. My sister used to do that to my arm. Well, at least once she did it. I probably ran after that. She'll have a good laugh watching this video. Eep. Man. Take my battle axe. Trim this up a bit. There we go. That's how you do that. One more minute and we flip it over. Make sure you watch your times because you don't want to cook it too long in the pan. Just want to put a nice brown on it. That gives you some extra flavor that you wouldn't have otherwise. Oh, I can't tell you how that smells right now, but it is gorgeous. Okay, well, I got 444, time to roll over. Woo, look at that. See, what did I tell you? Nice brown, look at that. We're gonna give it 3 more minutes. That's 47, 447, it'll be ready to go into the crock pot. And we will be right back. Okay, it's 3 minutes on each side. We're gonna do the edges. Woo. It's about a minute on each one of these sides, ought to be enough. pan is really hot. I'm going to go ahead and turn the stove off. And that's it. Into the pot it goes. Wow. And now I gotta move this out the way. Whew. Let that cool down a bit. And we will be back in a few minutes. So now I think we're ready to add the rest of the ingredients. Put the corn right there for a second. It's gonna go on top. That's my topper. The rest of that stuff is gonna go right in, just like that. Mushrooms included. There we go. Get all that spread around. I'm using a thick slice on that mushroom, so. You can quarter your mushrooms if you like, do it that way, that's fine too. It is completely up to you how you want to do that. Now, I don't want to submerge the meat completely. I want to get it up about a good ways anyhow, two-thirds of the way. Gotta let that go down. It's kind of foaming, doing the foamies on me. I think two cans will do it. I had a third standing by, but I don't think that'll be it. Now I gotta let this sit over here because the stovetop is still a bit hot. I'll go ahead and light it up over here. Just gotta drag the electrics over to it. Not really a problem. We're gonna put this on high. And that's it. I mean, this is the miracle of crock pot cooking. It's like you just fire it up and go back to bed. That's what I'm going to do because I'm tired. I woke up, I was thirsty, and so I got a drink. And now I put the crock pot on, figuring, you know what, if I wake up early enough, I can do this and it'll be ready by midday. Easy enough. When I wake up, this is going to be smelling really good in here. So I hope you follow along. Look at the ingredients. I'll post them down below, just above the comment section. So it's real simple. You can do this. Anybody can do this. I'll be right back. So 3 hours later, we are back. Okay, I'm going to take a look at this. Whew. It has been boiling away. I might need that. Actually, I need the other one better, I think. There it is. I'm still moving in, so bear with me. I'm gonna sink them down if I can. Get them submerged somehow. See what that piece of meat's looking like. I think I need a fork here. I don't think it's quite ready yet. No, it's not quite pork tender, but it's getting there. Ow! Try not to splash yourself too much when you do this. That's going to be really hot. Oh yeah. That up. There we go. Whew. Whew. I'm going to take a taste of the liquid. even though I'm not really making a stew out of this. It's going to tell me what it needs. Needs a bit of salt, I think. Just a tad bit. I didn't really put anything on the mirepoix. Yeah, so let's get that going. There's always that. It smells so good. I can't tell you how much. Don't have smell vision. Oh, just a bit more. Just a wee of it. Now, I think some cracked pepper ought to be added to it. I gotta get me another one of these. This one's about done. Or is it done? It is done. Oops. So, there's always that. That happens. I'm going grocery shopping today anyway. I went out the other day and I forgot to get a few things. God, what's that like? Too much on my head. Yeah. And moving. Gosh, you know, moving is fast. Except when you get there. When you get here, you gotta unpack, right? That takes 4 times longer than packing, trust me, because now you got to unpack slowly and figure out where you're going to put everything. Good grief. And my kitchen is unfortunately half the size of the kitchen I had over at the last address, so dang, ow. Anyway, that's my story, and that's the way it happens. I'll be back in about 2 hours. It's 8 o'clock now, 8:12. So about 10:12, I'll be back. Okay, we're back. It's 10 o'clock. Almost. Close enough. Is cooking away. And what's the result going to be? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, it's definitely there. Oops. Oh no, I've lost it. That's the mushroom. I did lose it. It's gone down there into the bottom of the pit. That's all right. I'll cut me off another piece. I'll try and cut a piece. It's just breaking up. Yeah. Cool. It's nearly done, I would say. It's close, but it could be closer. Oh, I'm gonna get a plate. Definitely need a plate. Okay. Right. Oh yeah. I'm gonna lower it down to warm. Oh yeah. So, I'm filming today on my iPhone. I put it on a stand so I can use both hands. I see a lot of people doing it with their phones, but they're actually holding the phone with their hand. That's a bit awkward. It is really tender. Okay. I would say it's done. And so I put it on warm, and I'll be back a little bit later today. I gotta go do some grocery shopping. I bought an entree. Went to Olive Garden yesterday. And they sell those entrees for $5. So I bought one. They got chicken alfredo, they got, I bought the spaghetti with meat sauce. That's the one I bought. But there's not that much meat in here. So, what I was thinking yesterday was, that's okay. I'm going to add my own meat. And that's what it looks like. I'll simply put that on the cast iron grill, heat it up, drop some of that meat into it. Presto chango. That would be a nice dinner. Forget lunch. That's a lot. That's actually quite a bit. It's got some heft to it. So that'll be my dinner tonight. And I think with that meat there, it ought to come out pretty good. Even though I didn't cook it in any kind of Italian gravy or anything like that, it's going to come out real nice. That's really, really tender. And hot. Oh man. We'll be back with the final product. And I'm back. The meat's done. I just got back from shopping. Look at that. Look at that. Oh my God. Man. That just breaks apart. It is a bit hot in my hands, but now I know why to use forks. Wow. That is a bit getting hotter as I go deeper. So I get a fork out. I'll get two forks out. I'll be a two fork kind of day. Look at that. That is amazing. Look at that. Look at that. It's like pork. It's like pulled pork, isn't it? That's just what it's like. Wow. Mmm. I put it in the skillet so it'd be easier for me to manage like this. There's a piece of fatty tissue I'm going to remove. Wow, look at that. Woo. Just some connective tissue we can do away with. Don't need that. Don't need it. Don't want it. The less fat like that that we consume in our diets, the better. I was listening to the news today, and this doctor was saying, if you go out on a cold day and you dress light, you'll burn more energy. You'll even possibly lose weight because your body needs to stay warm. I'm not suggesting that you go out in a blizzard with a t-shirt on. Ow! Okay, I've done it, but it's cold. Don't do that. Now, you should lose some weight doing that. Wow. Look at that. That is amazing. I gotta have a taste of this. This is too much. Mmm. Oh, wow. Needs just a sprinkle of salt and pepper. That's it. There it is. There it is. There's my... No, that's... Here it is. Gotta make sure I grab the right bottle. Whoops! Wow. Okay. Second fork. Look at that. Mmm. Oh, that was amazing. Oh. That's going to make a lot of sandwiches for me, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. A lot of sandwich. I'll be in beef heaven all week. And let's see what we're going to do with that fatty tissue in here. I'm just going to take it out. This smells heavenly. Man. Just about got all that out of there. There's not much of it in there because I cut most of it out. So, now what you can do, and what I'm going to do right now, is I'm going to get me a tortilla, flour tortilla. You can use corn. Put some of this in it with some pico de gallo. Check my recipe on that. And bada bing, bada boom, that's lunch. My dinner, that's going to be that Olive Garden spaghetti. Stuff is still good. I made it a few days ago. Should be okay. Let's see what we got. Smells okay. Looks okay. Must be okay. Just give it a real quick turn. And a taste. Because I don't want to put... There's nothing worse than putting something that's no good on something you're going to eat. No, it's good. The cilantro is still green, so that's gonna go on one of these. Oh yeah, Cheeky brand. Didn't have my brand, so I had to buy this one. That's okay. Should be all right. Can get this thing to crack open. Come on, open up. Come on. There we go. Now you just take one of these and load it up. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah. God, that smells good. This is like barbacoa. Oh yeah. Whew. Man. Get my tomato juice out the way. Spoon might be better. Yeah. That's working better for me. Now, there it is. Got this today. Just under a dollar. We'll see how that works out. I've had it before, but a long time ago. Oh. That's my hot sauce. I need a paper plate. It'll do me right now. Okay, paper plate of this. And we'll just roll that up. We'll put that in the microwave for about 20 seconds. That's just to get the thing warmed up. I don't like cold tortillas all that much. So it just came out of the fridge. So I'll go ahead and put some heat on it. Oops. I'm knocking everything around. Look out. Grab a seatbelt. Okay. Oh. I forgot I put my tea in there earlier. Nah. We'll have some hot tea later. If I don't forget. Ah. Seconds. I made it hit a minute, but I'm only going to go for 20. Yeah, that's nice and warm. Oh yeah. Wow, that is good. You gotta try this. There's multiple things you can do with this. You can even make a Philly sandwich out of that meat. Not a problem. Wow. That's gonna fill me up for lunch. Bon appetit, my friends. You gotta make this one. It's really good. I'll put, like I said, the list of ingredients below. Oh, that's so good too. I put some of that in my tomato juice. Oh yeah, a Bloody Mary without vodka. Pretty much. Pepper, parsley flakes, tad bit of sea salt, and that hot sauce. Yeah, real good stuff. Well, have a good day, and bon appetit. Leave your comments below. And subscribe if you haven't, because you're not going to want to miss the next recipe, right?